Well, that's a good and complex question at the same time. First of all, you know, in terms of ESG, we do think that we bring a key contribution to make the world safer, greener, and more inclusive. In terms of defense, I observe that there is a real difference between US-based investors and European-based investors. In the US, it's not really a question. We are totally, I would say, in agreement with our investors over there that considers that there is no sustainability without stability. And defense plays a key role to have, I would say, stable economy, stable nations, stable countries. So that's why that was one, not the only one, but one of the purpose of this ESG Investor Day, to just explain how defense industry work. It's a very transparent, highly regulated and highly controlled industry among, I would say, other key activities of Thales, like cybersecurity, like space, like digital identity and security. Now, the future will tell if investors want or not, I would say, to support this kind of industry. But I'm pretty sure that, I would say, common sense will prevail at the end of the day.
If we can shift our attention to other parts of your business at Thales, away from defense, which is towards digital and tech. I read an interview where you are quoted saying that digital will have to face the same storm as air transport when it comes to carbon emissions. Can you explain this to us?
Well, in fact, what is called the digital economy or the digital sector, in fact, is unfortunately a key contributor in terms of CO2 emission. So it's something which is known now by many people. So to avoid the same kind of, say, headwinds that the civil aviation sector has had to face recently, we need to be, I would say, in advance. We need to be proactive. We need to demonstrate that the digital world and companies using digital technologies are taking into account now the CO2 emission or the climate change, I would say, challenge. And in particular, it means using, I would say, smarter algorithms that are, I would say, much more efficient in terms of processing power, hence in terms of energy consumption. And typically, that's what we are currently working on at Thales, and we call it frugal AI or frugal algorithm.